I know it's a bit late to review the Mitchells vs. the Machines right now because I just had the fathom over the Invincible finale, but holy crap, this movie's amazing! Only Phil Lord and Christopher Miller can make a movie plot so stupid yet so awesome at the same time. I actually thought this movie was going to suck, but it turned out to be one of the best movies of 2021, if not the best movie this year. The animation is amazing, the jokes are hilarious, and I really buy the bond between the family. When you got the producers of the Lego movie and the writers of Gravity Falls on board, you know you're gonna be in for a wild ride. I may have had fun with this movie, but unfortunately, there's only one major flaw I had in the movie, and that was the villain. The villain was honestly the weakest point of the movie for me. To think she started all this because she was thrown in the trash in the movie made no sense to me at all. But somehow, Lord and Miller actually made the villain funny even though the motive made no sense. That's impressive. Also, it has that infamous third act breakup cliche which happens a lot in anime and movies nowadays. If you don't already know, it's the number one trope I hate in movies. Like, a lot. But somehow, Lord and Miller made it not affect the story at all. And it honestly kinda worked. Usually when it happens, there's usually a big argument. But somehow, there's no argument at all. And I just wanna say, thank God. I absolutely hate that cliche, but they made it quick. That's also really impressive. But with that said, the rest of the movie is out of the park. I could make a top 10 funny moments out of this movie, but that would take up the rest of the video. Every joke in this movie works. The Furby battle, the dinosaur references, the pop culture references, the modern day jokes, they just work really well. They were better than The Big Bang Theory, which is just pop culture reference after pop culture reference. And the bond between the family works, especially between Rick and Katie. Despite its flaws, this is honestly my favorite film and the best film of 2021. The jokes are great, the characters are great, the animation is great, it's just a great film. Do yourself a favor and definitely give The Mitchells vs. the Machines a watch on Netflix. While it's not as great as Into the Spider-Verse, it's still a fun ride to watch. Phil Lord and Christopher Miller, if you watch this, don't stop making great movies. We need them more than ever. You are this generation's John Hughes, and I look forward to what ideas you come up with in the future. This is easily my 20th favorite film of all time. I highly, highly recommend The Mitchells vs. the Machines. I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. So what did you guys think of The Mitchells vs. the Machines? Did you like it, or did you think it could have been better? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Because this movie was certainly better than the disappointment that is My Hero Academia Season 5. Mushrooms? Seriously? Your power is mushrooms? What were they thinking?